I am absolutely done with that overrated, blubbering British buffoon Regal. He thinks Raw is better than SmackDown? Well, at War Games, the blue brand will reign supreme, especially with you as our team captain leading the way.
Hold on. Did you just name me SmackDown's team captain?
Yeah, why wouldn't I? You're our champion. You've had the title on lockdown for years now.
Yeah, despite everything you've done to try to take it from me. I mean, I assumed you were going to pick anyone but me.
Where is this coming from? You sound like Regal. I've been Team Dark Horse since the beginning. Man, I am shocked you think I feel that way.
Whatever, Miz. Who else do you have to round out our side?
I got your old rival Seth Rollins on board. But I figured I'd let you choose your other two teammates. See? Told you I'm on your side.
Right. So Seth and two other partners of my choice. I'll see what I can come up with.
Great. Make sure you choose carefully, though. Since Raw has all champions and an established faction making up three quarters of their team. But no pressure. You got this.
Here's the dark horse riding alongside an unlikely partner in Austin Theory.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 446 pounds, Victor Ross and Austin Theory.
Look at this. The champ and Theory walking out together. This is SmackDown solidarity.
I don't know if I trust Theory. He has one thing on his mind, and that's himself.
These fierce warriors are set to clash in this epic tag team battle. It's Viking time!
And their opponents, accompanied by Valhalla, at a combined weight of 552 pounds, Ivar and Eric the Viking Raiders!
The Viking Raiders approach the ring every night as if it's a battlefield, and they fight accordingly.
Yeah, holding back is apparently not in the Viking playbook.
But intimidation certainly is. These warriors are a scary sight.
If there's glory to be won, they'll burn this whole place to the ground to get it.
For many, the day the Viking Raiders graced their arena was the most important day of their life. But for the Raiders, it was Monday.
Some great tag team action in store as the Viking Raiders take on what reports say could be the cornerstone of the SmackDown Survivor Series team.
Austin Theory is a talented guy, and if he really wants to contribute to Team SmackDown and not just Team Theory, he would be great to have in War Games.
Well, Theory isn't just a talented athlete. He's smart. He knows that if SmackDown is doing well, he's doing well.
I don't know if there's any ounce of professionalism in an attack like that. Caught with a lariat.
Oh, my gosh, what impact.
Punishing the shoulder.
Oh, my goodness, dribbling.
Softening up their opponent for the discus clothesline.
Oof.
And on that exchange, it looked like Ivar lost some focus.
Big boot connects, crash landing on the outside.
This one is headed to the outside, not by choice. Hard to come back from that kind of impact.
And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
Oh, what a play.
Here's the cover. He's able to kick out before two.
It's not over yet. Plenty left to go in this one.
Able to get there in time.
Oh, jaw shattering.
Waist lock. Able to counter. Look at fighting out.
Manages to fight out with a series of punches.
Steered clear of that.
Fought off with an elbow.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
That was incredible. Those two are in such a cohesive rhythm out there.
It's like playing jazz, but using your opponent as the drum.
Doesn't bode well if you still can't get more than a one count by now.
That's going to fire you up with anger.
Big elbow drop.
A big kick to the gut, the clubbing forearm. Lined him up, boom, knocked him down, ouch.
Pff,
pressing, the foot to the back of the head, and then a stomp.
And Viking Raiders just got some of that berserker turned against them there.
Yeah, Theory came prepared for this matchup.
Whip back into the ring.
Drops the hammer
right on the lower back.
And Eric can't stop any offense coming his way. Looking at a fired up Austin Theory.
Eric able to take a stand there.
But Eric has to push now while there's an opening.
Snap power slam.
And now Austin is thriving off the audience.
Fresh man in.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Oh, strong impact.
Oh, he's debilitating forearm strikes.
Ooh, just relentless.
Just never had a chance to block any of those.
Getting set up for something in the corner.
Crushing impact in the corner. And an elbow for good measure.
Representing the blue brand like this, take a look at the talent that makes up the A show. Great reaction from Ivar.
The adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on his side.
No way.
Oh, no!
Oh, that was nasty.
No. What a crossbody!
Risking it all and able to connect like a homing missile.
And he gets delivered back into the ring.
He gets out of the way.
He got whipped into that corner. A hip press.
To put him away.
Gets the tag.
He's getting fired up now, really feeding off this crowd.
Picture perfect drop kick.
Oh, she has bad intentions now. Remove.
Theory looking for a win in the now.
Oh, the ATL.
Will that clinch it for Theory?
Tonight, at least, there's no way a guy with an ego as enormous as the Universal Champions puts someone who would outshine him like Theory on Team SmackDown.
Listen to this frenzy for L.A. Knight.
If any dummies out there don't know, now they know.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California. Weighing in at 241 pounds, L.A. Knight.
And according to Knight, the days of running your mouth without consequences are over.
It's the Warrior who's followed a dusty trail from the fringes to the spotlight.
And his opponent from Paradise Valley, Arizona, weighing in at 226 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Victor Ross!
There's a lot of hype surrounding this guy, but I'm not convinced there's enough talent to back it up. Frankly, I'm starting to think that Dark Horse is nothing more than a forgettable donkey.
Hey, donkeys play a vital role in agriculture, and this guy is playing a vital role in today's WWE.
Seriously, Byron?
LA Knight requested 5 minutes here tonight to show the SmackDown War Games team captain just what he's capable of.
I think it's a great idea. And now both of these sluggers are going to be throwing haymakers trying to get a fast victory.
Let's find out if LA Knight nails the audition or fails to get a callback.
Another one showing absolutely no mercy at all. What an onslaught.
Stretching and tearing at all the ligaments in the leg. Broken up with a fist to the face.
Sequence of reversals there.
Ow!
Sidewalk slam!
Almost drove him through the ring.
LA Knight got shown up that time with a stiff attack.
Not getting the two at this point has got to say something.
Knight doesn't have any room to recover.
Knight is going to have to dig down deep here.
Senton hits the target.
What a cross body.
What a forearm.
Softening up their opponent for
a discus clothesline.
Snapmare takeover. Basement kick to the side of the face.
He thinks he has it.
And still in this.
How? How? They are in position. Their opponent has no idea what's coming. LA able to get out of the way.
A stalemate of counters. Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
Get on over here. I'm going to break your back.
And now Knight is getting...
Look out! Oh, no!
That was an absolutely haphazard, uncalculated risk.
And I have no doubt they're going to pay dearly for it.
Oh, neckbreaker!
Battling at ringside can be very unforgiving. You have to be careful out there.
No protection out here. No safe confines to speak of.
And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
Yeah. Knight giving the WWE Universe the chance to really appreciate him.
Whoa, beautiful blockbuster. Coming down with a leg drop.
He foiled that attempt.
Oh, we might be close to the end.
He can really stand to give back as good as he's getting right about now.
Uh-oh, look out. Missed it.
Nailed it.
Of elbows to the temple.
Quick exchange, reversing the reversal.
Caught with a clothesline. Knight in a state of distress. stress.
Yeah, but Knight needs to remain resourceful in this situation.
Boom, what impact. Placed in the corner. Boom, what a right.
Gosh.
A back elbow with a snapmare. And follows it up with a corkscrew elbow.
This is going to come down to who wants it more.
Oh, my gosh. What on earth is coming next?
Is it enough to put Knight away?
Conceivable. How does this guy keep beating the odds? I don't believe it.
It sounds like he had money on his opponents or something. Start believing, Corey.
He really tried, but LA Knight couldn't get it done here.
The following is a men's War Games match. The rules of the match are as follows. Two teams will be contained in separate cages, with one member of each team starting the match. At regular intervals, alternating members from each team will be released to enter the match. The team with the advantage will be the first to have a member released into the match. Once all competitors have entered, War Games officially begins.
The match could be won by pinfall or submission, exiting the cage, and result in a forfeit. Now, let the war games begin! Introducing first, representing the NWO. From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 280 pounds, Scott Hall! And from Paradise Valley, Arizona, weighing in at 226 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Victor Ross!
Thank you.
Here are your winners, Victor Cross, Rick Steiner, Scott Steiner, and Braun Breaker.
It's over. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Men is for the undisputed WWE Universal Championship.
The Viper, ready to strike. A storied career with plenty of historic wins.
Yeah, Randy has every right to rest on his accomplishments, but he hasn't.
Kept evolving his game, continuing to grow as a competitor.
That's exactly, Michael, why Randy Orton is so dangerous. In fact, you could say that Randy Orton is better now than ever before.
There is no question, Randy Orton is one of the most vicious competitors we've ever seen.
I agree, Saxon, and his venom is as potent as ever. Orton knows how to debilitate any opponent.
Once the fangs come out, Orton aims for the kill. It's a superstar who couldn't be denied and now electrifies the WWE Universe.
And just listen to that crowd. He's a universal champion who is quickly becoming universally beloved.
More like universally overrated. The fans may adore him now, but let's see how long that love affair lasts.
The reins are off, and it is on.
Introducing the challenger from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 275 pounds, the Viper, Randy Orton! And his opponent from Paradise Valley, Arizona, weighing in at 226 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Victor Ross!
The championship of all championships, and the biggest prize in WWE.
Possession of this title puts you in a league of your own.
What a huge risk the WWE Universal Champ is taking. Putting up his title just for the chance to put Randy Orton on the SmackDown War Games team?
It really shows how much the champion cares about SmackDown to take this big of a risk.
Or maybe it's just overconfidence. Maybe he doesn't realize what a huge threat Orton is.
counters the Viper's attack. A jumping stomp to the gut. Oh, what a kick.
Ooh.
A knee drop delivered.
So precise.
Staved off that attack.
Whoa, a single arm back body drop.
Orton looks a little less dangerous after taking that attack. The Viper in bad shape here.
Orton's being kept in check.
Oh, Enziguri.
Slam down.
In control here with a swinging neck breaker.
Textbook.
Sends him into the corner. Randy Orton gets him back.
Gets dropped. Timely reverse DDT.
Countered it just in time. The challenger not looking good right now.
And this match is not over yet. Things are only going to get harder from here. Good grief, man. This is vicious.
Nothing was being held back with each of those strikes. Did you see that? Propelled through the air. Nightmare takeover. Pow!
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Staggering to his feet, but he won't like what's coming next.
Cut off with a kick to the gut.
Boys.
Uh-oh.
Fights back and drops him with the bulldog. The Viper is facing a bit of danger here.
The Viper might be feeling a bit rattled.
Good grief, man. This is vicious.
Into the corner. This can't be good.
He's managing to get some control back now.
He's showing it's not time for lying down. It's time for fighting back.
Suplex.
Running senton.
This could be big. Going up high.
Soaring.
Sky high. Low down. And he's adamantly in control. The advantage is squarely in his corner.
Getting that shoulder up now is huge.
He has him right where he wants him.
Orton's finally able to slow all of those incoming attacks.
Good chance for him to regain his wits.
Get on over here. I'm going to break your back. Playing possum. Shoulders down. Oh, the champ narrowly kicked.
Try and end it.
Retains the title.
Here is your winner. And still the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Victor Ross!
Another incredible win for the WWE Universal Champion.
Every time you think this guy's down, he finds a way to pull victory from the jaws of defeat.
What a title defense by the champion.
Yeah, he left it all in the ring tonight with the type of performance that's defined his title reign.
Eric Bischoff? What's he doing here?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, representing the NWO from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 195 pounds, Eric Bischoff.
Does anyone know what's going on?
Pay attention to social media, Saxton. Stone Cold Steve Austin told the champ to stun Eric Bischoff, and apparently he's following through. Looks like he got Eric some hair dye, too.
We've got a WCW throwback. Who is ready to throw down?
It's the Dark Horse with a touch of Texas Rattlesnake.
And his opponent from Paradise Valley, Arizona, weighing in at 226 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Victor Ross.
This is getting stranger by the minute.
I'm not surprised. We know Eazy-E is all about controversy and cash. The Dark Horse provided the cash to get Eric here, and now let's see how controversial this will be.
This cosplay clash is about to begin.
They say imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. Well, I hope Stone Cold Steve Austin feels flattered tonight.
If the champ can stun Eric Bischoff, Stone Cold Steve Austin will have no choice but to eat his words and join Team SmackDown for War Games.
Not a single word you just said makes any sense in the year 2024, but I am here for it.
Oh, man.
Leg sweep.
Senton to follow.
Moonsault.
An unrelenting assault being brought to Bischoff.
Bischoff's on the wrong side of every exchange.
Boom! A forearm smack!
Oh, timely counter by Bischoff.
Oh, strong impact!
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit.
Look at that insult to injury with that one. The disrespect can be tasted in their mouth.
Two powers through after two.
He really thought that was it.
Getting up, but doesn't have a clue what's coming at him. Oh, snapmare. He's got him in the crosshairs.
Bischoff's in serious danger.
Makes the cover.
And this one is over.
Here is your winner, Victor Ross.
Eric Bischoff threw everything he could at the undisputed WWE Universal Champion. But now the champ can add Stone Cold to Team SmackDown.
Well, people say a lot of things on social media, and not much of it's true. We'll see if it actually happens.
Miz looks like he has a lot in his mind headed into Survivor Series.
Look out! From behind!
Is that a giant bunny? What the hell?
We've seen some strange things in WWE over the years, but a bunny beating up a GM is up there.
What did Miz do to deserve this?
And there was some force on that move.
He gets out of the way.
Oh, sharp knee.
Was ready for that.
Lands the knee.
Front face lock applied. Up and
their opponent driven down with the gourd buster.
Carefully measured.
Again?
The sailing the joints of the leg.